Okay, embedded messages. Everybody loves embedded messages because with embedded messages, you can do suggestions like in the suggestions page over here with Coralbot. You see that Pablo Escobar has suggested the following and there's an upvote and a downvote. Now, in order to get this suggestions enabled, that's actually fairly easy. All you need to do is you go to coral.gg and once you're over there, you select your server. I'm going to select Jochen's domain. Go down to commands on the left hand side and then once it loads you want to go all the way down the tabs over here to suggestions. Then make sure that your suggestions has been enabled and then go all the way down to the bottom on the left and you'll see under the utility section under suggestions you can then specify the colors that's associated with suggestions. You can vote the color intensity as associated with the suggestion. It's so much easier if you talk slower. Oh my soul. Anyway, so we've got the send DM on decision. So when there's a decision made, you will send a DM. You can edit and repost that suggestion instead of actually posting a new post altogether. So there's a couple of stuff. You can specify where to send the suggestions to and so forth and so forth. So that is that for how to enable suggestions in Coralbot. Because this is an embed video, not a suggestion video. Now, when you look at the embedded messages over here, you can specify in Coralbot how to name items. You can specify the numbers of it. You can specify the user image, the username. All those kind of things, and I'll show you how to go about doing that. So to get back down to our call tags, let me show you the tag builder in the dashboard. So I'm gonna go back to Coral. If you go down to settings, all the way down to tags, and in the tags, you want to create a new tag. Now tags are a little bit different. If you're coming from Dino, tags is kind of like custom commands for Dino. And then it's got the embed builder thrown in on that as well. Now you can enable the embed builder by just clicking show embed builder. And then this is the standard embed builder as per any other embed builder for Discord. Everybody uses the same format. So if you're used to embed builders, this is an easy way to go about it. If you're not familiar with embed builders, please have a look at my video that covers the Dinobot embed builder because you're going to have the same kind of fields over here. But I'll show you some fields to enter. And there's some neat features over here. You've got the, if you click on advanced, you can import and export your raw JSON. Now I'm going to show you how to create a post and embed that's similar to the suggestions, but we're going to rename it to feedback or something. Now I've already actually done it over here, but I'll show you anyway. So let's take feedback and make another one, right? So I'm going to edit the feedback one. Now you'll see in the embed builder, we've got the content. Now this content is your custom command content. So I want to delete this message after I've used the feedback command. I then want to redirect it to a particular channel. So that just outputs your embed builder to a target channel. In this case, it will be to a feedback channel. And then I want to react on the message with an upvote and a downvote button. Now, if we go back to the suggestions over here, suggestions. So that is the redirect would subsequently be suggestions. And then that upvote and downvote are these reactions that you see over there. Now, what we want to do is we want to specify in, what is it? In the icon URL, you want to specify the user avatar. Now, all of these combinations can actually be seen on the wiki page itself. So please have a look down. There's links to the wiki pages. Or if you really want to, you can simply type in RTFM. Oh, right, let me do that for you. You go RTFM embeds, and then it'll take you to the embedded link. Now, click on tags, by the way. If you go to tags and you click on advanced usage, this is where you can specify all those arguments that you can get. So they'll say, hey, for a user, you can also add avatar behind user, or simply like they've done this with user ID. So if you had user avatar, it would give you that user's avatar. User ID would give you the ID. User mention would actually mention the user and so forth and so forth. So all of these advanced object adapters will explain to you exactly the information that you can get out, and with that you can build up your message itself. Now, we want to use an avatar as the picture, so that is the picture of the user itself that'll be identified in the top left corner. The username will specify the username itself, and then what we want to call it. Now you'll see that I'm using here, I want to call it feedback, and then I want to specify the number of uses. Now these uses are what you see that's being tracked on the right over here. So on your dashboard you'll see a users one. Now that gets triggered how many times this has been used, and then that uses that count in order to specify it in the title itself. So that's a pretty neat feature, and that is ultimately how you get this this suggestion 49. That would be the 49th use of the suggestion command would have been added into there for you. Now next we've got arguments. So we want to specify that all of the arguments after the feedback command is then added as content to this embedded message. Now that's basically the message. So if you want to feedback something, if you want to suggest something, all the text that you put after that command will then be added into this. Now you can add additional fields if you want. Personally, I didn't do anything on that, and that's it. You can add a footer, you can add a footer icon, you can even add a thumbnail URL if you want to add your branding to your logo over there. And then once you're done, you can just save that, and Bob is your uncle. I hope Bob's your uncle, or maybe I don't hope Bob's your uncle. Either way, you will be done with that. And then all of a sudden, you've got a feedback embed message. Now, I can just simply go here and I'll say, feedback, this is great. Great. And it'll delete that message. You'll see this is just a trip. Can't delete it because it's already deleted. That's a caching issue, by the way. If you do encounter that, that's a caching issue. If you cannot delete it manually, it's a caching issue. Anyway, so I deleted it. I redirected it to the feedback channel. I then specified the user, the user avatar. And I specified the username, feedback, and the number of uses is 1. And then the content is the arguments. And then you can upvote and downvote. That's easy enough. Now I want to show you how to steal embeds. This is the coolest feature ever. I've been using it so many times. So what we want to do is embed source, the message ID, and from the channel. That gets you the raw JSON from an embed. That's any embed, people. As long as you have anything, that's any embed. So I'll go show you how that works. So what we want to do is we want to go embed source, and then the ID of this message, and then the channel in which that message is in. So we want to go, this is the suggestions channel. Now as soon as I enter that, it actually kicks out the exact raw source of that embedded message. So this is the exact source of this embedded message. Now what we can do, I'm just going to clean this up quickly. So now what we can do is we can go back to CorelBot. And when you go into your feedback, so let's create a new tag altogether. Say this tag's name is new tag. Hey, new tag. But what we can do is in the show embed builder, go to advanced, click on import, and paste the raw JSON and apply. Look at that. It's all done. It now pulled in all the message information for you in the relevant locations. So you still want to go edit this a little bit. So I want the user avatar over there. And reload, new tag, there we go. And then when I go back to my test environment, that was how we steal embeds. We can actually make use of that embed source to see the source of any kind of embed and get you going on that side. And then finally, we can even convert embeds to other types. So that is now what I showed you. Once you have stolen that and once you have edited it, I have taken essentially the suggestions embed, I have reworked it to now be a feedback embed, and now in my server, even though CorelBot doesn't come out with a feedback command, I have created a feedback command or a feedback tag that has a similar kind of format. It goes to similar kind of feedbacks, and then you know who it's from and so forth and so forth. So really, really, really good feature. And as always, if you guys have liked this, please click that like button, subscribe to my channel, check out my Patreon if you want to support, and please come and join Discord. We have got a great community on Discord. Come on in. We don't necessarily do things for you, but we will help you in figuring out how to do it by yourself as well. So really good supportive community over there. Please come and join us. Anyway, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time. Yoken out.